Hey, what's up, dog world, bully family? This is your boy Zeke, Bully Badass TV. It's been a minute. It feels like it's been long, you know, since I've actually posted a video where I talk to you guys and I get you guys feedback. And, well, I miss you guys, so I'm glad to be doing this, and I look forward to you guys commenting on this video. Also, if you would, like and share it, and if you haven't already, please subscribe to the video. Today, I wanted to talk about, I get a lot of questions about people contacting me looking for a reputable breeder or a good breeder, and I want to address that in this video real quick. Before I do that, though, let me just send out a couple of shout-outs to some folks who have always supported me. First, I want to send a shout-out to my man, Wolfpack Kennels. He's a good dude. He's one of the first people to sell my DVDs. You can find him online at Facebook, Wolfpack Kennel, facebook.com/Wolfpack Kennels. Wolfpack Kennel, I believe, is his Facebook page, and Wolfpack Kennels is his fan page. So you guys should go on, sign up, connect with that brother. He has a lot of great things for people showing. He sells show leads and other bully gear, I believe, specifically for the show ring. Then also want to send a big shout out and with a heavy heart to my man James Cooper, BullySupplies.com. His boy, 13 years old, passed away today. You know, that's everybody's, any dog owner, any pet owner, anyone who loves their dogs, it's like your biggest nightmare. Feel for the brother. Wish him nothing but the best. My man James Cooper, your family, my heart is with you. I told you this morning, you did right by your boy. And, you know, at this point, we can all just, you know, just be strong through this moment. That's all I can say. Again, you know, my heart is with you. All right, so let me jump into this video real quick. What this video is about is, like I said, I get a lot of people hitting me up asking me about do I know any good breeders in a certain area, or, you know, can I recommend a good breeder to them? And let me just say quickly, like, I'm really, to be quite honest with you, I'm really heavily active in Southern California area. I'm not really, and I got some calls about some people down south, some people back east. And I'm just not that big yet, I guess. I don't know all these people. But I do believe that, you know, that when you guys hit me up and asking me that, you guys kind of just asked me, do you know any good breeders? But no one ever tells me what exactly they're looking for, what style of dog they want. What are they planning to do with the dog? You know, it's like, you know, a guy that's breeding show dogs is not, a guy that's looking for show dogs is not going to want to go to a guy that's breeding exotics. A guy that wants an exotic dog is not going to want to go to a guy that's breeding show dogs. So all I have to say is that I feel bad because I can't, you know, I would love to be able to, you know, solve everyone's problem, give everyone a great answer. But unfortunately, like I said, I'm not everywhere. I really haven't been outside of Southern California a lot. Most of the kennels that I deal with are in Southern California. But, you know, for 2014, the plan is to get out and be more, at least more national, you know, getting around in more places in the United States. So I'll probably have better information. But again, you guys have to know what it is you're looking for. You know, you can't just ask someone, I'm looking for a breeder. Well, what kind of dog are you trying to buy? And so those are the questions that I would say to anybody. So since I really can't answer that question, it's probably going to be a long time before I can answer that question. Or, like I said, it's just hard because, you know, I don't know everybody. I don't go to everybody's yard. I don't know really what kind of business people do. When Bully Badass TV comes to a yard, everyone puts on their best face. So I tend to like everybody I meet and would recommend anybody yard that I would shoot, anybody that I've worked with, I would tend to recommend them because I realize that they put their best face on for me, and I appreciate that. I put my best face on when I'm doing business. I think it's appropriate, and I think it's smart business. But you also hear stories about people who weren't satisfied with people. So, you know, and that's always a tricky thing as well. So for me, what I would just suggest is if you look, first of all, figure out what you want. You know, Facebook is a good resource, but don't be mystified by Facebook. A lot of people are, you know, photoshopping images. I think I talked about that before. People are, you know, Facebook is just probably a good place to do your initial research. Then you probably want to You know, you got to just do investigation. It's a tough thing, man. Buying a dog, you know, spending the kind of money that people are spending on dogs today is a tough thing. I wish I could be more helpful. But I mean, it's just a tricky thing. I mean, the most important thing that I would say is know what you're looking for, know what you want, identify it. You know, do your research on the dog, the style of dog, understand like how long these dogs live in, understand the kind of medical things, medical issues that these dogs may or may not have, and be prepared. So just really all you can do is at this point, do all your due diligence, do your research, understand the breed, understand the dog, understand the style of dog. That you're looking to get. Understand what you're trying to do with the dog. You know, if you want to breed a dog, if you want a dog and you want to go into the show ring with that dog, then you need to be looking for a breeder that has bred dogs that have had success in the show ring. I mean, with the exotics, it's different. I mean, honestly, you know, for exotics, is to me, it's kind of like, you know, it's just different. It's more of a business proposition. It's not so much of a you know, buying a dog for a pet or for a show ring. It's really like, you know, you find a name that's hot right now or that might be hot next month. You get it. You take some nice pictures of that dog and you go about the whole process of marketing it. That's how that exotic thing works. And I'm not judging that. I'm just saying that's more so how it works. You know, you don't necessarily, when you're looking for an exotic dog, you're not looking for a show dog. So there's different criteria that you should use in determining whether or not, you know, what breeder you want to go with in terms of who dogs, you know, who has a program that's hot in the community, you know, how much are they selling their dogs for. If it's a business thing, like I said, I'm not judging. People do it all the time. you know, I would just say, you know, you guys just have to do your due diligence. I really can't, unfortunately, I can't be more of assistance. I know a lot of people look at me and think like, oh, you know everybody, you know everybody's yard, you should be able to tell me who should I buy a dog from. I know a lot of people, and I know a lot of people who have different things. Very few people, as for all the yards I go to, very few people are competitors, you know. Some people have micros, some people have micro exotics, some people have extreme exotics, some people have extreme show dogs or classic show dogs or, you know, standard show dogs. It's just, everybody's doing something different. So without me really knowing exactly what it is you're looking for and what it is that you want to do with the dog, it's really hard for me to tell you, you know, who to go to. But I will say this. If me, personally, if I'm going to buy a dog from anybody, I want vet records. If the dog is supposed to be papered, I want papers. I want kennel registration papers. I want vet records first. You know, I want a paper trail on that. I wouldn't mind seeing the vet records on the parents of the dog. And that to me would be the first thing, the first place I would go, along with the internet and doing my research. Those are the kind of things that I would look for. Again, very sorry that when you guys send me this stuff, like I said, I would love to be more helpful, but I really can't because it's just not something that I've been, you know, I've been more so just focusing on creating media. I'm not a breeder, so I don't really get into, like, you know, analyzing people's yards for breeding purposes. And I'm not buying dogs, so I don't really understand exactly how people do business on that level. So hopefully this answers some questions, and, you know, maybe you guys, you know, can find some solace in the fact understanding that, you know, I don't really know everything, but the information is out there to be had, so you guys just have to do your research. I'm going to leave it there. I don't know what else to say. But anyway, I really appreciate you guys. Again, heavy heart. Big shout out to the homeboy Cooper. What can I say? It's always tough at this time. I'm going to leave it there. Thanks so much for watching. I appreciate you guys. Please like, share, comment. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to Bully Badass TV. It's 2014. It's a new year. We're going to do bigger, better things this year. Onward and upward is the mission. And hopefully, you know, we bring the whole bully world and dog community with us. Peace.